The LG Indoor Mini Split motherboard display is defective, as half of the display is working and the half display is not. As it is not understandable what the display is trying to show. Let's find out if it is repairable or not. Now I am separating the motherboard from inside its cover. For removing the motherboard, I will push this plastic hook. The motherboard has easily come out of its plastic box. Microcontroller is installed over here in this control board. And let me check what are these three IC for. I have checked them. These three IC are Darlington arrays. And I couldn't see any IC in the back and on the front that is installed to control the display. There might be only LED lights inside the display. Other than this, the control IC for the display could be installed inside the display. This is also possible that the microcontroller itself is controlling the display in this motherboard. Now I am removing the display to check whether any control IC for the display is present inside it. The 7-segment display has a sticker on the top. It has nothing inside it. This means no IC is present inside the display. And the microcontroller controls the 7-segment display. Any wire could be cut off, connected between the motherboard and the display. Because two wires connector are connected between them. I didn't find any wire that has been cut. The connector is also soldered fine. No connections seem like they have broken. The second connector pin solder also seems to be solid. This means the LED inside the display could be damaged. Oh! See over here what I found. All these resistors over here are kind of rusty. And due to this sometimes, the resistors will not work as resistors. They will be more conductive and act like a simple wire. All these diodes over here are contaminated and oxidized. It is rusty from here as well. So let's have a look on the back side of the display. The rust has also formed here on the back side of the display. This rust makes conductivity on those places where it is not required. Now I will clean these diodes and zener diodes. But before that, let's check what is beneath the 7-segment display. See, I have pulled the 7-segment display from the display circuit. You can see it is completely rusty from beneath. The possibility is that some LED lights might be bad due to this mess. This is only a cover above the LED light. I will clean all this rust from the display circuit. I am using petrol to clean the display of the circuit. Turpentine oil can also be used to clean such kinds of circuits. Petrol is easily available, so I would recommend cleaning it with it. Some of the rust has got solid on the circuit. For that, I am scraping it with a scraper to remove it. I will have to check and clean each and every corner in this circuit. Now after cleaning it looks something like this, it is far better than before. This LED light had been removed from this pad while cleaning it. This means that the pads on this LED got vanished due to rusting. The same has happened with this LED. These LED lights got bad due to rust. Now I will test its display in the motherboard to make sure how many LED lights are bad in this display circuit. I have passed electricity now. I will turn the motherboard on with the switch. Only one LED of the display has turned on. Now I have turned it on with the remote. And some more lights have turned on. But not all of them are turned on. This LED is completely dim. Now I will order this small size of LED light because I don't have this size of LED lights. And this means that the microcontroller is controlling these LED lights. These three transistors are also used to on and off the LED lights. The first transistor will turn on half part of the display lights. The second will on the second half. And the third will be used to turn on the remaining display lights as programmed by the microcontroller. If any one or all these transistors and the Darlington array IC go bad still, it could make this problem. I have ordered the LED lights, and our order will take 2 days to arrive. Till then, I will check the LED lights using this super LED backlight tester. Almost 19 LED lights are installed in this display. So these LED lights could be of 5 or 3.3 volts. So let's check what voltages are these LED. I have passed electricity through the backlight tester. Now I will switch it on with the power button attached to it. It shows 300 output voltages on its display panel. This means 300 volts DC are passing through these probes. This means I will not touch these probes as they could give a shock. And work very safely using this tool, because safety comes first. So let's check the first LED. I have placed the probe around the LED. The LED has turned on. The tester has 3 volts on its display. The tester has automatically adjusted the voltages and passing the required voltages across the LED to turn it on. This first LED light is 3 volt LED. The second LED is functioning abnormally, means it has gone bad. I will mark the bad LED with a black marker while checking them. This other LED is showing 9 volts. So I will change the polarity of the probes. And it glows after changing the polarity. This is also a 3 volt LED light. Now let's check the other LED. This one is also of 3 volts. All the LED lights in this circuit are 3 volts. This one okay. This next LED is also okay. This LED is not glowing on both the polarities, which means this is bad. The next is okay. This LED is bad. So I have checked all the LED lights in this circuit. After 2 days of waiting, finally the LED light I ordered has arrived. Let me show you what sizes do we got. As you can see, these are quite tiny LED lights. These are the 4 sizes I got from the part dealer. Now I got a very small problem, which is that the LED lights I got are warm colored, but I needed white colored. All of these are orange colored lights. Now I will remove the LED light from the circuit, which are bad. I have soldered all the LED lights. But mistakenly the soldering clips of the LED I filmed on the microscope got deleted. So I couldn't show you that. And as you can see, I have soldered all the LED lights. I have soldered the traces as well. It was quite difficult to solder them as they were too fragile. Now I have attached the display with the motherboard. And I have power on the motherboard. One LED light has turned on. And this LED light is for indicating the on and off indicator. Now when I change the mode of the motherboard through the remote, these LED lights are working something this way. These are not still functioning fine. Now I have set the mode on cool through the remote. And on cool mode, the lights are working something this way. The number should have been displayed on the circuit. I have set it on 26 degree, but the light are not indicating it through the lights. Now when I decrease the temperature, the light turns off. This means it is still not working fine. The error has started to blink on the display. I have removed the electricity from the motherboard. I will remove the display connector from the motherboard. You can see I have repaired the through holes which were disconnected from the back side of the display. I also fixed the traces from the front side of the display. You can see a wire is attached with the resistor in the broken trace of a through hole. I tested it again and more of the display lights turned on than before. This light is glowing dimly due to a short circuit in the display. This means the display still has a short circuit or broken traces. And after a lot of hard work and repair, I finally decided not to work more on this display as it consumed a lot of my time. And I realized that this display is going to be replaced with a new one probably. And if you watched the video till here, hope you enjoyed the process of repair. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.